Episode 1 is entitled Victorian Steam Railways and starts right at the very beginning of the cinema itself, back in 1895. All known surviving railway film from the period is included.
242 Bourbonnais class locomotive and allows the sweep of the gleaming wooden carriages to achieve its maximum effect. Sprinters, see, quick starters and nifty runners. It's all very reminiscent of the famous races to the north of the 1880s. By the way, the film has not been cut. The British 440 Express engine is the very class that hauled the train on that fatal night. Now onto the scene for the first time on film, a powered means of road transport. Totally enclosed, hopefully consuming its own smoke and steam, the steam tram with its trailer car.
The Edwardian scene begins with the first major milestone in the history of the cinema. The invention of the story film. Many of these early stories just happened to revolve around trains, and thus it was that by sheer chance, railway scenes were filmed for posterity.
You will have noticed that we have, as in all our clips, adjusted the film speed to the original silent standard, so the actors no longer move about. Here is a James Stirling B-class loco, one of only two fitted with Holden's patent oil-burning system in 1900. You can clearly see the oil tanks instead of the usual coal bunker.
So all over the vast works, covering many acres of ground, the individual parts were made and machined until they all met up in the giant erecting shops, where the individual pieces eventually became finished railway engines.
At speed, on a water trough, somewhere on the Great Western Railway.
Pre-grouping is the name given in Britain to the railway era before the 1st of January 1923. Here's a classic 080 of the Lancashire and Yorkshire Railway, originally built by Aspinall in 1900 and later developed by Hughes. After a long line of wagons carrying raw cotton, many with Lancashire and Yorkshire tarpaulins, comes an added bonus. It's a banking engine. Some old Leylands left over from the First World War. And just look at those wobbly front wheels. It suggests they couldn't have moved at much more than walking pace. And some were only 2 horsepower. This is the film that inspired Sir John Betjeman's famous television programme about Metroland, a trip from Baker Street to Uxbridge and Aylesbury. Of course, only bits were shown in the TV programme, but here, for the historical record, is the entire surviving film. An all-too-brief shot of a Prince of Wales class piloted up the Euston Bank. Mr. Lartigue's fantastic monorail was expected to revolutionise rural railway transport, but it never really caught on. One place that did make use of this quite extraordinary European invention was on the Listowel and Ballybunion on the west coast of Ireland. Both engines and stock were made double so as to straddle an A-shaped set of metals that supported the centre of the train. This is the Duke and Duchess of York, a arriving on a special London and North Eastern Railway train and being greeted by the officers of the new company. A special grandstand had been built just for the occasion. This is George Stephenson's Hetton Colliery locomotive of 1822, complete with overhead beams and still in steam. The locomotives in the procession moved at 6 miles an hour in order to accommodate such old-timers. Number two in the procession was Derwent, a Stockton and Darlington locomotive built in 1845 by Timothy Hackworth. Cornwall, built by the London and North Western Railway in 1847. Henry Oakley, built by the Great Northern Railway in 1896. North Eastern Railways, the pre-grouping years. I hope you'll now be able to enjoy the complete series.